Chapter 14 Sources of Energy. What is energy? Energy is the power to change things. It is the ability to do work. Energy is defined as the ability or the capacity to do work. Energy lights our cities, powers our vehicles, and runs machinery in factories. It warms and cools our homes, cooks our food, plays our music, and gives us pictures on television. Energy sources. There are two forms of energy sources. Non-renewable energy sources, renewable energy sources. Non-renewable energy sources are energy sources that cannot be replaced and will eventually run out. Renewable energy sources are natural energy sources which do not get used up. Let us learn briefly. Sources of energy, renewable. Energy sources that are easily replaced or available on a perpetual basis if managed properly. Non-renewable energy sources found in limited amounts, they are used up much faster than they can be replaced. Characteristics of source of energy. A source of energy is that which is capable of providing enough useful energy at a steady rate over a long period of time. A good source of energy should be safe and convenient to use, easy to transport, easy to store. Fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are coal, oil, petroleum, and natural gas, solid, liquid, and gas. Solar energy is stored in fossil fuels as chemical energy. Fossil fuels come from within the earth and are concentrated sources of energy. Fossil fuels are rich in hydrogen and carbon. Gasoline is made from petroleum. Burning fossil fuels creates air pollution, which may lead to global warming. Advantages of fossil fuels. A major advantage of fossil fuels is their capacity to generate huge amounts of electricity in just a single location. Fossil fuels are very easy to find. When coal is used in power plants, they are very cost effective. Coal is also used in abundant supply. Transporting oil and gas to the power stations can be made through the use of pipes, making it an easy task. Power plants that utilize gas are very efficient. Power stations that make use of fossil fuel can be constructed in almost any location. This is possible as long as large quantities of fuel can be easily brought through the power plants. Solar energy. Solar energy is the energy obtained from the sun in the form of heat and light. The heat energy is used in solar heating devices like solar cooker, solar water heater, solar furnaces, etc. The light energy is used in solar cells. Solar cooker. The box type solar cooker has an insulated box painted black inside. It is covered by a glass plate which allows heat to enter inside but does not allow heat to escape out. It has a mirror to reflect more sunlight into the box. The food to be cooked is kept in containers inside the box. It can produce a temperature of 100 degree to 140 degree Celsius. Solar water heater. A solar water heater has an insulated box painted black inside with a system of copper tubes. It is covered with a glass plate which allows heat to enter inside but does not allow heat to escape out. When water flows through the copper tube, it absorbs heat and becomes hot. Biomass energy. The waste materials and dead parts of living things are called biomass. Example, wood, animal dung, vegetable waste, agricultural waste, sewage, etc. Biomass is decomposed by an anaerobic microorganism to produce biogas. Biogas is a mixture of gases containing methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, and hydrogen sulfide. Biogas plant. The biogas plant has a large underground tank made of bricks and cement. The lower part is the digester and the upper part has a dome with a gas outlet. On one side of the tank above the ground is a mixing tank and the other side is an overflow tank. Animal dung is mixed with water in the mixing tank and the slurry is sent into the digester. In the digester, the slurry is decomposed by anaerobic microorganisms and after a few days, biogas is produced. The gas is taken out through the gas outlet and used for heating and lighting purposes. The slurry left behind is rich in nitrogen and phosphorus and is used as manure for crops. Hydropower. Hydropower is energy obtained from moving water. The water turns large turbines which produce electricity. Geothermal. Geothermal energy is heat from melted rock deep below Earth's surface and can be used to heat buildings and produce electricity. Wind. Wind energy is used to turn large turbines. These turbines produce electricity.
If you like the video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Nanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.energyhub.com.